Let's balance the equation for carbon plus sulfur dioxide, C plus SO2. So I've counted the atoms up. The one thing you want to be really careful about is we have one carbon here and one here. So 1 plus 1, that gives us 2 carbon atoms. Make sure you count all of those. I'd like to leave carbon here until last because carbon's all by itself. When I change this here, the coefficient here, it won't change the sulfurs or the oxygens. So let's just balance the sulfur atoms. If I put a coefficient of 2 in front of the SO2, 1 times 2, those are balanced, and 2 times 2, that'll give me 4 oxygen atoms. Again, let's leave the carbon till last. If we put a 4 in front of the CO, the carbon monoxide, 1 times 4, that'll give us 4 of those. So those are balanced, and we need to update the carbons here. So now we have 1 carbon here plus the 1 times the 4, 4. So we have 5 carbon atoms. But the carbon's by itself, we just put a 5 here, 1 times 5. We are done. This equation is balanced. If you wanted to write the states, they look like this. Carbon's a solid, sulfur dioxide and carbon monoxide, those are both gases. And then this CS2, carbon disulfide. This would be a liquid at room temperature. It's actually neurotoxic, not very nice stuff, but it's used a lot in organic chemistry to help make other chemicals. So that's it. That's the balanced equation for C plus SO2 yields CS2 plus CO. This is Dr. B, and thanks for watching.